Hi everybody, happy Wednesday. For the past 2 days, I have been so off my days. I kept thinking today was Thursday, I thought yesterday was Wednesday, and so forth and so forth. I have just been out of it. The allergies acting up, and it's beautiful today. I'm actually welcoming the bad allergies because it has been scorching. It has been hot for weeks, and we finally got some rain, a little light thunderstorm last night, and it was just wonderful. I was just loving it. Everything is just nice and cool today. It's not hot. It's just perfect. I shouldn't be out here. Orders by the doctor. I shouldn't be outside when it's after a rain or when it's raining because all the moisture just irritates my allergies, but I'm welcoming today because it's just been hot. But anyway, I want to come to you today with something more of on a positive note. You know, the last couple of my videos have just been pure anger, but it was just on those days, you know what I mean? I'm not angry all the time, but I wanted to just change the tone up, because we need it, you know what I mean? I need it, you need it, we just need to change the tone up, because I don't want to come off as a complete angry black woman. I just want to come off as somebody who's angry sometimes. You know, once in a blue moon, I'll be angry, and you've seen it, and so let's just change the tone up, so I don't want to, you know, come off like that. But let me go ahead and get started into this story I want to tell you, okay? This is just a nice little romantic story. Let me just give you a background thing. I won't even get into the meat of it yet. Like Tamiya says, I don't want to get into the meat and potatoes until I give you the appetizer first. Okay, so let me give you the quick appetizer, which consists of bacon, eggs, and a little bit of grits on the side, and a buttermilk biscuit. In my little town that I live in, I'm related to half the county, okay? And I say that because I have a humongous, huge family. And most of them consist of people that I don't even know. And don't even know me. And the only way you may know each other is somebody points it out. Or I'm riding with my parents. And my mom or dad will point out, hey, that's your cousin from such and such side on my side. And all this stuff like that. I'm like, I don't know who that person is. You know. So I have family, a huge family base here in this particular town, which got in the way when I was in high school. I couldn't really date anybody in high school because I was related to half the guys. If your last name was such and such, oh, we were related. It may not have been direct like my uncle or my aunt, but down the line, we are related. So I couldn't really date in high school, which didn't matter to me because, honey, all them boys that I went to school with anyway were just all thugs and whatnot. You barely had, like, some good guys in there, and that some good guy was, like, on my one good hand, so it didn't matter to me if I couldn't date in high school. I was going to wait until college anyway, and now I'm done with college and just still didn't find him. But anyway, so I'm related to pretty much half the county, okay? And so my mom doesn't really shop that much in town because she doesn't want to run into anybody, which, when I was younger, I didn't quite understand that. I was like, Mom, they're family. Why would you, you know, try to avoid them? And now I understand, as the years went on, I understand exactly what she means. For me, I cannot shop anywhere in town without running or seeing a classmate of mine or a family member of mine. And then when I see me, it's to the point where if I'm going to Walmart and I'm on a mission to get a few items, I don't need to be sidetracked by somebody else because then I forget what I came in there for. And then I leave the store and won't realize that I forgot what I needed to get until I get home. So I understand what she means now. So she doesn't do a lot of shopping in town. She usually does, well, if it's groceries, then she'll go to town. I mean, obviously, she'll go to town. She won't go out of town unless there's things that she can't find in this town that she has to go out of town for. So when it comes to grocery stuff, she'll shop in town and just bear with the fact that she may run into somebody who she knows. And but if it's Walmart, see, we are some avid Walmart shoppers. Now, Walmart can be pirates, and Walmart can be unjust with the way they treat people and their employees and whatnot. And I know this firsthand because, you know, my brother works at Walmart. And so I know Walmart can be evil sometimes, but we love Walmart. I don't think, like I said, New York, I don't think North Carolina can live, function without a Walmart. I don't think anybody can function without a Walmart. I'm sorry, just Walmart is all that. So we are some avid all Walmart shoppers, right? And proud of it. And this hat came out of Walmart. So when it comes to Walmart, my mother would shop out of town for that. Now, she will not go in town and go to Walmart. I don't necessarily have a problem with it if I could go in, pass the people that I know, get what I need to get, and once I've purchased what I need to get, it's okay if we talk for maybe like 2 minutes. I'm not going to sit here and have a full conversation with you, okay? I will just, you know, ask you how you're doing if you speak to me first. Or if I see somebody that I really haven't seen in a while that I was really close to in high school or growing up with, then I'll go to you and speak to you for a little bit, find out how you're doing because I haven't seen you since we graduated. Or I haven't seen you since you graduated, if you were older than me or whatever. And we grew up with each other. And then once I find out how you're doing and you're doing fine, then I'll go on about my merry way. Now, Mom does not like to shop in this town, Walmart. So we go out of town to this other town. I won't call the name because then you know where I live at. We go out of town to this particular Walmart, and this Walmart is a lot better on occasions, because this particular Walmart is way out of town. In fact, it's in the next state. We'll go to the next state to go to Walmart. But it's not the where we live is close to Charlotte, but it's close to the next state. To South Carolina, so we'll go down to South Carolina and go to Walmart, and it's not that far. It's like probably a 20-minute drive at most. So we go to this particular Walmart, and there is this young man who works at the electronics section. There's a cat. I won't mess with it because I don't have a problem with cats. There's this young man who works in the electronics section. Now, when I go to Walmart, the first place I go is to the electronics. Okay, because I am a gamer. Strange looking cat. I am a gamer, as you know. So I'm going to go straight to the electronics to see what is out in the Wii section, in the PS3 section, in the PS2 section, and in the Xbox section, okay? And for the past couple of years, there's been this young man who works back there. And to me, now he comes off to me from observation, a very quiet gentleman. He talks a lot. But he looks very quiet. I actually do find him attractive. I do find him attractive. Not attractive to the point where as if it was Gacked or B-Rain, okay? If we wouldn't even be talking right now. I'd be dating him right now. Hey, just saying. But I do find him attractive. I actually think he has, like, the most beautiful eyes. He has, like, beautiful almond-shaped eyes. And, he just comes off as a very quiet, subtle dude. Now, he does not dress like those, you know, those thugs we see on the street with his pants all the way down. He doesn't do that. He actually is a very clean, decent young man. And, wait a minute. Before I even continue with my story, the enemies are going down the road. Let me just... Okay. Now, speaking of those people, because that's who that was, they have resorted to throwing rocks down. Not throwing, like, rocks, like, coming into our yard, because they can't do that. They've gone to the point where they're just throwing rocks over the fence that my father has now barricaded us in. We are completely barricaded. And they have now resorted to throwing rocks. And my dad is like, that is stupid. They're throwing rocks. What is that? Anyway, back to the store. I figured you might get a laugh out of that. Back to the store. So I would hang around in electronics, you know, in the game section. And I may walk around to the DVD section because now all my favorite cartoons... are on DVD, and of course Family Matters is on DVD now, so I always go to the movie section every now and then on occasions to kind of see what's out. And if you haven't known already, Johnny Bravo and Courage the Cowardly Dog will be out on DVD. Well, Johnny Bravo is out on DVD now. Courage will come out this month, next in July, okay? So I gotta go to Walmart and buy those because I love Johnny and I love Courage. So I go there and I look at the movies just to see. Now, I have on occasions... Just because I had to make sure that when I go in there, the whole point of the story is, when I go in there, he is eyeballing me the entire time, okay? When I'm walking through there, he's always trying to look and stare, you know, look like, in fact, prime example, last Saturday, me and my family went out, and we went to that Walmart, okay? And what are we going there for? We went in there for something. Get some groceries or something. And, my sister and I was roaming around and we were getting all the things that we wanted to get, and we went to the electronics section. We stayed around there for a few minutes and kind of looked around, and you know, and I went and purchased, I started getting into these things called crazy racers. They're food shaped racers, which you know they're from Japan, they're food shaped. Well, they're shaped like food. So I've gotten to the thing of collecting them, and everybody's making noise with their cars. Good grief. So I've gotten into the point where I'm collecting these erasers, which I may show you in the video if you're into that kind of stuff. I have this crazy love for stationery and cute stationery and just paper clips and sticky notes that are shaped like stuff and all this kind of thing. So I got a crazy thing for stationery. So I went into this Walmart and found, which is the only place I could find. I'm pretty sure these other Walmarts sell them, but I can't find them in there. So, but in this particular Walmart, I know where they're located. And I was buying these crazy erasers, okay, because that's what they're called, crazy erasers. And I bought those, and I actually bought Woody from Toy Story 3, because I saw Toy Story 3 last Friday. I thought it was the greatest Disney movie of all time, and I have a crap load of Disney movies in there, and I've been moved by every one of them, but I was never moved like I was with Toy Story 3. It is the best Pixar movie. It is the best Disney movie, period. Just my opinion on that. It was amazing. So I bought Woody. They actually have like these big pillow-sized Woody and Buzz, for $15 at Walmart. So I bought Woody. I got the crazy erasers, and I bought some snacks that my sister wanted, and got me a Dr. Pepper. Because if you don't know already, I'm a big Dr. Pepper lover and a strawberry soda lover, and chocolate lover. So I bought me some Dr. Pepper with the other items that I had, and I went to his checkout in the electronics on purpose. Now, if you don't know the checkout routine in Walmart, you can check out anywhere else if you didn't know that, which I'm pretty sure you already know that. But I went to this checkout in particular because it was closer. I was in the section, and he was working. So I went up there, and I put my items up there, and you would think, with all of the looking and staring and trying to kind of follow me through the store, he doesn't follow. I won't say he doesn't follow. Look at my hummingbirds. He doesn't follow necessarily, but his eyes seem to always be there. So I went up to him and I put my stuff down, and he was having a little trouble scanning Woody. Woody would be the one to mess up. And I think Woody had a tag on him. Now, mind you, Woody had a tag and barcode on him, but for some reason he would not scan, and it made me stay in that section at that register longer than I wanted to be. And the guy was trying to get it to work, and, you know, he's typing in all these numbers on the little keypad that's in front of you, you know, right beside the thing where you swipe your debit card or whatever, and it would not work. So I was trying to make conversation by saying, I cannot believe, what did I say? Oh, I said, I cannot believe Woody would not scan. I guess I had to go and get another Woody. I must have said that twice. I guess I had to get, and it sounded strange now that I think about it now. I said, I gotta go and get another Woody. So, it sounds stupid now that I think about it. I didn't catch it then, but I'm catching it now. And I was like, I got to get another Woody. So, he didn't say anything. He didn't even crack a smile, really. But he finally got it to work. Because I was serious about that. I was like, I may need to get another toy with a workable barcode. But he got it to work eventually after maybe 2 or 3 minutes just standing there trying to get that thing to work. And he got it to work, and he scanned my other items and my other snack stuff, and he gave me my stuff, and I remember what else I bought. I was buying headphones for my sister, and I got all my items and I left with my sister, and we were heading back to meet up with our parents and leave the Walmart. When we left the register and was heading down to the main walkway of the store, you know, in the front of the store, the biggest floor in Walmart, I heard somebody call my name. Ma'am, you know, I don't know ma'am, that ma'am is not my name, and I don't expect other people, strangers, to know what my name is, but I don't answer because it's not every day that somebody calls me ma'am, you know what I mean? So I turned around, and it's him running up towards me, and he was like, ma'am, you forgot this. And I looked down, and it was the headphones that I bought my sister. I totally forgot. I got all the items. I had this big bag of stuff. And so I figured, usually, this never happened to me before, but I figured all my items are there. And I always double check. But this particular time, I didn't double check. Because I figured, with this big bag of stuff I'm carrying, because Woody was the biggest thing I had, I figured everything was in there. But he was like, ma'am, you forgot this. And he gave me my headphones. And I said, oh, thank you. And I said something else, too. Like, something that I was trying to ease the moment. I think I said something like, oh, I always forget something, or whatever I said, and I took it, and he actually smiled. He actually cracked a smile. And then he walked off. Now, as my sister made it to the front and mom and dad were checking out in the front, in the register at the front of the store, we sat down on the little benches there next to the bathroom, because I think mom had to go to the bathroom after she checked out. And I have these hummingbirds that just love to come and drink from this nectar I got out here. And they all, the gray one, I have two of them, a pretty green one and a pretty gray one. I just totally left the story. Let me just tell you this real quick. And a pretty green one and a pretty gray one. And the gray one always flies up really close to the screen here and look me in my face all the time. He just always does that. The green one does it, but when I look at him and try to zoom in and look at him closer in his face, he kind of flies away. But the gray one doesn't do that. Anyway, I love my hummingbirds. And they come back every year. I think this is like the third year that they come back because they know where to go. They know where to go. So as we're sitting there waiting for mom to come out of the bathroom, me and my sister sitting on the little black bench thing that they have in front of the store, you know. There he was. I was talking to my sister, and I looked up in the corner of my eye, in the vicinity of my eye, and he was standing there talking to one of his fellow employees. The whole time, I'm looking at my sister, okay, because, well, I'm looking at my sister to the left. She's sitting to the left of me, and I'm talking to her, and I can see him. So, I'm looking at my sister with my left eye, and I'm looking at him in my right eye, if you can imagine that. And the whole time, his head would just turn into my direction just the whole time. He would turn away, you know, and if whoever it was he was talking to him, and he was, you know, speak back. But the whole time, he was just, the whole time. And I'm thinking to myself, okay, we have been dancing around each other for two years straight now in this particular store, okay? It is obvious, and I hate to sound cocky. I hope this doesn't sound cocky because I'm not trying to sound cocky, but it is obvious that you want to say something, that you are attracted, because anybody who stares at me that hard all the time, every time I go into that store, I mean, you gotta say something, you know what I mean? There's something that you want to say really bad, but you just don't know how to approach me, that's what I'm thinking. He doesn't know how to approach me. He doesn't know what to say. He may be nervous. He may be shy. Who knows? But I tried to make conversation. He didn't respond. I mean, he literally did not respond. I was just saying, you know, I need another Woody. Maybe I need to go and get another Woody. That's probably why he didn't respond. He was like, she does not realize how weird that sounds. But he didn't respond, is what I'm saying. So I don't really know what else to do, okay? Unless I have to switch into my bold black woman mode, go up to him, pull him to the side, and say, you know what? This has been going on for 2 years. You need to say something. Is there something that you need to tell me? Because every time I come in this store, your eyes are on me. All eyes on me, okay? Tupac, all eyes on me. Because every time I come in there, you want to say something. And every time I go into this game and say, well, you know I'm a gamer, that's probably the one thing you probably like. That's probably why you stare at me all the time. Is how you know I'm a gamer, and I'm in the gaming section. I bought more games than I can think of out of this particular store if I can't get what I need in the Walmarts in my state. So you know. So I don't know. He won't say anything, but any opportunity that he wants to say something, he doesn't. It's because it's just me. Maybe he doesn't say anything because my sister is there, but even then, I leave her in the games and I go to the movies. He has his opportunity, you know what I mean? But, oh well. But I wanted to share that with you because I figured you'd want to know if there's, because some people have been asking me, is there a boyfriend in life? How come you don't have a boyfriend? You're like this awesome girl. How come you don't have a boyfriend? To be honest with you, I don't know why I don't have a boyfriend. I do have standards. They're not high. They're not so high that they're impossible to meet. But I do have standards, you know what I mean? I won't settle for less. But this particular guy, he's a cute guy. He really is cute. He really is. He is not ugly. No, he's not. He is really cute. But the mere fact that he's not playing hard to get. Lord knows he's not playing that. But the mere fact that he is so scared to say anything, it's kind of just like, you know what? We'll play this game. Because at this particular point, I don't think I even want to speak to you on that level until you make the... Because I don't want to have to be the one all the time that has to make the bold move. You need to make that move as a man. You need to make that move. So, that kind of thing. But I just want to... If anything else progresses out of that, because it usually does, it's always an adventure every time I go to that Walmart and it's him. It's always a different adventure. So if you want to know more about that, let me know. And I'll just tell you the story. But that's really what's been going on for 2 years. And he has not said anything to me yet. And my mom has picked it up now. She's picked it up now. And she tried it this one time. She actually tried, this was actually a month or two ago. She tried to have a conversation with him, you know, ask him, does he go to school? Is he a student? All this, just 411 mess. And then, so she can come back and report back to me. Because she tries to play matchmaker sometimes. She's like, hey, there's this cool young man. And Lord knows he's just as sweet as he could be. And he's in your age group. And I'm like, Mom, please. I find my own men's. You know what I mean? She's always doing that. But she almost embarrassed me one time in front of him. That was so embarrassing. She called my name out for something. She was like, come on, let's go. And I'm like, Mom, I am 23 years old. I am not 13. You do not need to call out my name. I got a cell phone here. You don't need to call out my name to tell me, come on, let's go. That was so embarrassing. I'll never get over that. That was just so amazing. She did it right in front of him. Anyway. Before I end this video, because I'm sure it's gone on as long as it has, it should have been, longer than it should have been. There is a person that I want to introduce to you, who's been a very loyal follower and subscriber, here on YouTube and on Twitter and now on Facebook, who wants to share his talent with you, okay? He's been doing this for a while now, and he wants to put his voice out there so that you can hear him. Now, he's a singer, okay? And to me, personally, I think he has a beautiful voice, okay? He's a very well-spoken young man. Just, to me, very handsome guy. He's going to make you ladies scream and all this stuff like that. So, I want to introduce to you Jamar84, okay? You may have seen him comment in my comments before. He's a fellow gamer. I cannot talk for nothing, excuse me. He is a fellow gamer, and he is a fellow Sims fan, too. So check out Jamar84 right now. Listen to his voice, and then leave your comments down here and let him know what you think of his voice, okay? He sounds beautiful to me. He'll be singing to you this song called No One by Alicia Keys. I think he does a beautiful rendition of it, better than her, to be honest with you. That's just my opinion on that. And I hope you like it, okay? So, Jamar84, this is for you. This is your moment to shine.
Hello, YouTube. This is Jamar, and if you are seeing this video, then I have to give a big shout-out to my girl Whitney from YouTube and Twitter. She's allowing me the opportunity to sing for you guys. I've wanted to get my voice out to a wider audience, to more people, so people can see it and hear it and give their opinions. I'm sorry for my hair. I'm going to get this done later. But I'm going to be singing No One by Alicia Keys. It's one of my favorites, and I hope I'll be able to do the song justice. I just want you close, where you can stay forever. You can be sure that it will only get better. You and me together through the days and nights. I don't worry, 'cause everything's gonna be alright. People keep talking and they can say what they like. I don't worry, 'cause everything's gonna be alright. No one, no one, no one can get in the way of what I'm feeling. No one, no one, no one can get in the way of what I feel for you. You. You can get in the way of what I feel for you. Thank you very much. If you want to follow me on Twitter, you can follow me at twitter.com/Jamar84. And if you're not already following Whitney, hers is twitter.com/BlackEssence. Follow us both. We're great people. We're funny. And hopefully you'll see me again. So goodbye for now.